There, good boy.
Good
boy, that's right.
Good boy.
Good boy.
This is Dunkin' Donuts, a 12-week-old rescue dog named by his 16-year-old owner, Chelsea Merrill, who always wanted to be a vet, had a smile for her family, and loved the Twilight movies.
Yeah, look at our pillow.
Nice.
Chelsea, show them your pillow. Say, look who's on my pillow.
Not long ago, Chelsea was a vibrant, healthy, busy teenage girl. The first sign of trouble was the summer before high school. Chelsea told her dad her eye was twitching, then her arm and leg.
Dad, I am seeing fireworks. And I said, okay, now this is bothering me. What's going on?
Neurologists suspected seizures. Drugs would work for a while, then stop. A sleep study showed Chelsea's entire brain was misfiring.
Chelsea had 4 tonic-clonic seizures in 15 minutes. It took them 4 rounds of rescue medication just to try and to get her to stop shaking enough to get her into the ambulance.
By Thanksgiving, Chelsea was suffering through almost constant, unstoppable seizures. With no diagnosis yet, her father did some online investigating about progressive myoclonic epilepsies. What he discovered was unimaginable.
I found out then that there were 5 of them, and so I started reading about them to see if anything happened to coincide. And the first 2, yeah, kinda, but when I hit Lafora, that was the 3rd one I started to read. I didn't even finish reading. I knew, in the back of my mind. I just shut the computer off and started praying.
Lafora disease, so rare there are only about 200 recorded cases, a genetic, progressive form of epilepsy that begins in adolescence. There is no cure.
With the dementia setting in, and she has bad hallucinations to the point where you gotta just be very patient and sit and try and piece together what she's saying to you.
I'm on TV.
You are. You are on TV.
The Merrill family pulled together, determined to stay by Chelsea's side, no matter how painful.
There's no really keeping it together. Sometimes, you know, one of us will cry or get frustrated, and there's not a way for us to kind of cope with what's going on. We just have to deal with it.
If this family has any peace, it's in knowing Chelsea's story is finally being told.
She just wants to live. That's her dream. You know? And if I don't fight and push hard to have her story told, I'll feel that I've failed her.
The Merrill family is planning a special birthday party for Chelsea this July and hope all of her friends will turn out. If you'd like to learn how you can help this family or for more information about Lafora disease, check WMUR.com and click on Health. I'm Jennifer Vaughn, WMUR News 9.